So we're going to talk a little bit about why it is okay to calculate an odds ratio for a case control study design. So you might recall that the odds ratio is the odds of getting the disease given someone's exposed relative to the odds of the disease given they're not exposed. Okay, we're going to work this out using the following 2x2 table set up in the conventional ABCD format. Okay, and I generally am not a big fan of using the ABCDs to work out odds ratios, but we're going to present it this way for the sake of working through the calculations. A reminder that the odds ratio, again, is the odds of disease given exposed over the odds of disease given they're not exposed. And if you recall, probabilities, right, the odds of disease given exposed can be written as the probability of having the disease given they're exposed divided by the probability of not having the disease given they're exposed. Right, so again, odds are a ratio of occurrences to non-occurrences. And the odds of having the disease given someone's not exposed, we can write this as the probability of having the disease given they're not exposed divided by the probability of not having the disease given they're not exposed. Right, so again, the odds is a ratio of the probability of occurrence to probability of non-occurrence. Right? So conditioned on having not been exposed, what's the probability of disease? What's the probability of not disease? And if we work these out numerically, the probability of disease given someone's exposed, right, so given they're exposed, that's conditioning on this row here, and the probability of disease is A, right, over A plus B. A over A plus B. The probability of not having the disease given they're exposed, and again, we're conditioning on the individual being exposed, and the probability of not having the disease is B over A plus B. The next few I'll move through a bit quicker and we won't kind of labor over all of these. But the probability of having the disease given someone's not exposed is C over C plus D. And the probability of not having the disease given they're not exposed is D over C plus D. Now, I'll let you play around with the algebra, but if you work this out, this is going to come out to A over B divided by C over D. Okay? Or we can express this as AD over BC. Okay, so you may recall this formula. Odds ratio is AD over BC. Okay, so first note is why I don't like using the ABCDs. I think it's a lot more intuitive, rather than saying the odds ratio is AD over BC, that the odds ratio is what are the odds of getting the disease for someone who's exposed relative to the odds of disease for someone who's not exposed. Okay, so think of the odds ratio this way, tells you what it is. ADBC doesn't actually tell you what it is. Okay, so let's get back to the idea of the case control design. Right, if you remember case control, we select people who have the disease, we select people who don't have the disease, and then we ask about their exposure. So in that case, when we've selected people based on disease status, we can't actually estimate these prevalences here. Right, we can't estimate what's the probability of disease given you're exposed. Well, we've selected people who are diseased, right? We've selected them based on their disease status. Same with these, right? So we actually can't estimate those, right? What's the probability of disease for someone who's not exposed? Well, we've selected them based on whether or not they're diseased. We're going to look at this now. There's some very convenient mathematics that happen for us. So let's take a look at that. The odds ratio, if we've selected people based on exposure status, right? We can't estimate anything about disease, okay, or prevalences, but we can estimate about their exposures. Right? So we can estimate what's the odds that someone was exposed given their disease relative to what are the odds that someone was exposed given they're not diseased. So the odds ratio we can get at is, you know, what are the odds of exposure for someone that's diseased relative to not diseased. Okay, and these are fine to estimate for a case control design. Right, we haven't done anything to control exposures in that sort of design. Now let's expand on this here. The odds of exposure given someone's disease, we can write as the probability of being exposed given their disease divided by the probability of not being exposed given their disease. Right, so again, the odds is a ratio of occurrences to non-occurrences. And expanding this here, this is the probability of exposure given someone doesn't have the disease, divided by the probability of not being exposed, given they don't have the disease. And again, let's write what these are in our table in terms of the A, B, C's, D's. The probability of being exposed given someone's disease, and again, that's conditioning on this column here, right? Given that they're diseased, what's the probability of exposure? A over A plus C. And divided by, what's the probability of not being exposed given they're diseased? Again, conditioning on the disease column, right? The probability of not being exposed is C over A plus C. And again, I'll fill in the bottom here a little bit more quickly. The probability of exposure given they're not diseased is B over B plus D. And the probability of not being exposed, given they're not diseased, is D over B plus D. Okay, and again, if you play around with the algebra and cancel out some of the terms, you're going to find that this comes out to be A over C, right? These are going to cancel each other out, over B over D, okay? Or AD over BC. Okay, so you can notice here, while technically for a case control design, we cannot estimate anything about prevalence, we can't estimate the probability of disease given exposure, okay? So we can't really estimate these here. It happens mathematically that the odds of disease given exposed divided by odds of disease given they're not exposed, mathematically happens to be equal to the odds of exposure given disease, odds of exposure given they're not diseased. Right? In a case control design where we've selected people who are diseased and not, and then asked about exposures, we can estimate these here. We can estimate prevalence of exposure for someone who's diseased or not. Okay, so again, just to note that this is why we can estimate an odds ratio for a case control design. And one final kind of nice feature to talk about. You've probably learned, or you will have learned, that in certain cases, an odds ratio, while a bit more difficult to interpret, right, for our brains, it's approximately equal to the rate ratio when is that? And that's for rare disease. Right. So we've encountered that rate ratios are a little bit nicer for our brain to interpret, or a bit more intuitive. Odds ratios aren't. Okay. But we've also learned for rare diseases, and guideline, you know, something with a prevalence less than 5% or so is the guideline for a rare disease. In that case, odds ratio and rate ratio are approximately equal. And let's think about case control designs. What's the most common use for those? The most common use is when we're studying rare diseases, right? If we were to do a cohort and follow people over time, we might not get enough cases of the disease. So we start by selecting people with the disease, people without, and then look back for exposures. Okay, so we get this really convenient loop that the odds of exposure, sorry, the odds of disease given they're exposed, over the odds of disease given they're not exposed, happens to be equal to odds of exposure given disease over odds of exposure given not disease. Okay, so we get in this nice loop where we can estimate the odds ratio, and we can interpret it this way, as these two are mathematically equivalent. And also for case control designs, often the reason we're using them is because we're studying rare diseases, and in that case, the odds ratio is approximately equal to the rate ratio, and we can interpret it that way.
Thanks for watching our video. Subscribe to our channel. Share our videos. Stick around, guys, because we got lots more. Statistics is almost as yummy as chocolate.